Well, today we have here what is this device to which we are going to be able to recover it in a very easy and very simple way. In this video tutorial, we will explain step by step how to recover your device. The first thing we are going to do is watch the video tutorial step by step until the end to be able to solve what is the deletion of the account of this device. Since it has a screen lock, it also has the forgotten Gmail account. This method that we are going to do in this video tutorial, we are going to do a method totally by PCEH. I always recommend watching the video tutorial step by step so that you cannot miss any of these details and you can be able to solve what this problem is with this Google account. Well, what are we going to do? First of all, we are going to connect to a Wi-Fi network to be able to do this process. Let's connect to a Wi-Fi network. After we connect to a Wi-Fi network, we're going to give it a tour of the device so that you can see that our device is completely locked since it has a screen lock. Also, finally, it has a Gmail account. Well, in this video tutorial, we're going to use a tool. This tool is fully updated for those people so that they can download it and install it correctly. Before, you can download this tool and run it, since these tools, you have to temporarily deactivate the antivirus. Since our computer, any computer, will recognize it as a virus, so we deactivate the antivirus temporary and then we run that tool. We're also going to have all the drivers, they're going to have they're going to be just like. We're going to explain in this video tutorial, we're going to give it here where it says use my Google account, and as we can see our device is totally locked since it has a screen lock. Well, another thing that I want to tell you in this video tutorial, we're going to use what is an EDL cable, since these devices have a Qualcomm processor. These devices have a Qualcomm processor previously with this processor, what we did was uncover our phone, do what was the test point, and so we could eliminate what is the Google account. Well, today we're going to be able to eliminate it, but we're going to use what is a USB cable that we have in our house, and what we're going to do is strip. What are the tips? We're going to strip the green color, and the black color are the two that we're going to strip. We strip the black cable and the green cable, both when we have it stripped. Now we're going to explain how to do that point so that our device can be recovered in an unnecessary way. To be able to uncover it. Well, let's go to what is the PC, and they will be just as I'm going to explain to you. Well, the first thing we're going to do is go to what is our PC, and what we're going to do is look for our antivirus. We're going to look for our antivirus and we're going to deactivate it. We're going to deactivate it temporarily. We're going to do this temporarily. We click here where it says protection against viruses and threats, where the shield is. Then we go here where it says manage settings. Here we're going to deactivate the first option. We deactivate it, will ask you to confirm. You're going to say yes. After having done that, we're going to go to what is our browser. We go to our browser and we're going to write exactly as it appears here. We're going to write Davidson. Look carefully how it appears. We write it ends in DL. Then we're going to look for the Android TV Davis option. We're going to click here, we're going to go to what is our official page. Here we have several entries where we're going to be able to find several totally different methods. Now we're going to look for the last entry that appears here that says apps diesel. We're going to select that entry here. We're also going to have other totally different additional methods so that you can also apply and can solve what is the problem of the elimination of accounts. of these devices. What are we going to do? Let's go. We are going to find here in this entry the program. As you can see here, we have the program. This is the program that we are going to download. We also left the drivers. In this program, we have left those drivers so that they can also install it correctly. Now, what are we going to do? Well, let's extract. We extract the program. We extracted then that we extracted. We are going to run it. We are going to right click. We click run as administrator. We are going to say yes, and then the installation is going to begin here. We give it next. Next, we give it create a shortcut. We give it install. We wait a few seconds until the program installs completely. When the program is completely installed, the program will leave a shortcut on the screen. The program will also run. When that program is run, it will give us what is the option to log in. Let's wait a few seconds for our program to open. It will open. It will appear like this. Then you will click here where it says log in, and the program it's going to open. When the program opens completely and correctly, then we're going to explain the following. As we can see, the program has detected. It has not blocked. It blocked us. Click here in history. Let's go. We click on history. We click here. We have finished running the program. We say yes. Let's see. We click here in actions, and we click here in restore. We say yes again. Ready. Let's see if now it lets us run the program and it opens. We right click. We click run again. We say yes. Yes, and now we're going to wait for our program to open. We're going to arrange to be able to complete the process. Let's arrange ourselves. Well, here we have what are the MediaTek, Qualcomm, Unis of processors. But this time we're going to select where it says Samsung. We also have for Xiaomi, Oppo, Lenovo, and many more brands. Now we click here below here, we will be able to find all the phones. The models, the process that I'm going to do today is for all those models. The process what I'm going to do is for all this reference. That appears here, you will be able to find all your reference. All this model, the same process is for all. For all those models, we also have up to the latest ones, which are S24, S23, S22, and many more. Well, having said that, I'm going to select my model. That today we are going to do the test with a Samsung A52. There is the F and there is the M. This we are not going to make a mistake. Mine is the A52 of 525 meters. The process is for all. The same process is for all. Here we have what the drivers are. We install the drivers. Here we have the Qualcomm processor driver, and this is a good driver that I also left in the program, this one that says LIP USB. This helps us. This program helps us to see how to install our driver. If it is not installed correctly here, we will be able to read it. We will be able to read and install it. We can leave it here to one side. Leave it here. We are going to click here where it says services. Here we are going to click here. We have already selected the binary model. We click where it says reset. Here it is. We are going to place the LIP now. Now here it will ask us to connect our phone. What we are going to do is turn off our phone. We are going to click off. We turn it off now. Here we are going to click here where it says install next. Here the drivers will appear. If it doesn't appear to you yet, the Qualcomm will appear here. Well, what are we going to do? Let's go with the EDL cable. It is going to be connected. What we are going to do is press these two. These two, the two cables that are stripped. Both the black and the green, we are going to hold it. We are going to insert it while we press volume up. Volume down several times quickly after we connect. We release the green cable and the black so that it does the. We are going to connect it, press volume up, volume down, now we release the tablets. Well, we try again here, we got what was an error. We do it again, we disconnect it. I am going to give it a couple of turns like this better times and we are going to do it again. We went to the cable volume up and volume down, we do quickly, we release. Here, oh sorry, I did not do the port, we do it. Again, we do it again, I am going to give it a little turn. And then untangle the cables volume up, volume down at the same time several times until it doesn't read them. It turned on for us. Well, sometimes when that option comes up, so it falls on us. What we have to do is turn on our phone and turn it on again. Well, let's try again. We glue the two cables. We are going to introduce what is the USB cable while we press volume up and volume down at the same time. We release the cables, both the green and the black, that makes a bridge. Ready, there it goes. As you can see, there it is. It is doing the process. Let's leave it. Let's let it finish. Here it is. Let's leave it as is. No file comes out here, but don't worry, now it will come out successfully. Now you will see what is a little box here on the screen. Let's wait for it to do the process here. You are going to say no, you say no, and as you can see here, a successful one came out. Now, but let's say that suddenly the process did not work for you. What you are going to do is this option here, when you get Qualcomm, if it was not successful, it did not give you successful. But it came out the processor which con here. You're going to click here, you're going to select it, and you're going to click install, and it's going to install correctly. When you click install, it's installed here. You click accept here and out, ready, it's already installed. But since our process was successful, then what we're going to do is press the power button, volume down button at the same time until our phone restarts. Come on, we're going to press those two buttons. Ready, when it restarts, what we're going to do is disconnect it. Now what we're going to do is wait for our phone to start correctly, and you're going to see that our process EH was successful. That easy and simple, we have recovered our device. But what happens is that when we recover our phone, they leave us with some errors. And we always recommend correcting those errors. And how are we going to correct it? Well, as you can see, accessibility appears here. When we have some errors left, we are going to correct them. We are going to explain what to do. We are going to click here on configure manually. Here, we are going to deactivate the Wi-Fi networks. If we have any without a card, remove that SIM card. We remove that SIM card. We are going to remove it to make the configuration faster. We click here where it says do not copy. We click more, accept. We click here on skip, skip, skip. Well, now we are going to wait until we click here on configure, adjustment more, then we click now on skip, we click accept. Now when our phone has some errors, what do we do? Well, let's go to settings. Here in settings, let's go to About Phone, we click on About Phone. Here we'll find the reset option. We click on reset, we click here on reset factory settings and we're going to delete all that information. When our phone completely restarts, what we're going to do is be able to configure it as we did a while ago.